Hi, I'm Steve.
And I'm Ryan.
We're the two mortgage guys.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to this week's episode of Show and Tell. Lou Ann from Springfield, Missouri writes to us from Facebook, wants to know about locking in her interest rates. What's it mean? When do you lock? What's that getter? Why would you do it?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Rates, yeah. That's the whole thing. Rates right now currently are just like the stock market. They're up and down. And so, you know, one of the things that we try to always explain to customers when we talk to them on the phone is the same thing on that. We don't know from day to day now what rate's actually going to be. Put us back 10 years ago, we were pretty good at it. We could look at the market and sort of give an idea of what was going on for, you know, a week or at least, you know, the next month or so that's what was going on. Today's market is completely different. We've talked to people who's been in this industry for 30 years that can't guess. We actually get reports, Ryan and I do, daily from two or three different companies, and there's sometimes they'll tell you to lock, and then the next day the rates are better than what they were today.
Yeah, but not always that accurate, are they?
No, so it just switches back and forth with it.
The reality is this, these interest rates, it's a lot like getting gas. I tell people all the time, it's like getting gas at the gas station. You ever drive by, you look, it's $1.83, mm-hmm. and the next day it's $1.84, and you still don't get it, and then you go by 2 days later, and then you're on E, you have to get gas, it's $2.13 a gallon, you don't know what the heck happened. It's kind of like interest rates. Something happened with the price of that barrel of oil, which made that gas go up. Same thing happens to interest rates. There's a blend of money markets, bond markets that affect the interest rates that lenders can offer. The reason you want to lock is so that you can get your interest rate that you like, get it secured, set in stone, and know when you get to that closing table, that's the rate you're going to have.
Right. Wipe your forehead, know that you're done, that's what your payment is, and you're comfortable with it.
There's some average terms. Typically 15 to 90 days, I would say, is the lock windows that you can secure. Depending on the type of transaction you're going to have, you may need to lock it for 60 days. I think you've got a purchase going right now where they can't move in until sometime in late June, so we need to lock that loan a little longer for them. It's not going to take us all long to get the transaction done, but they need that window. They don't want to gamble that the rates are going to go up, so they want to lock it for a longer period of time.
And on that, with the locks, just so everybody understands on that, if you lock a rate for 30 days, you're actually going to have a little bit better pricing than what you do if you're at 60 days or 90 days. Now, it's not changing at a point or anything like that, but it could bump it an eighth because of the way the pricing is on it. But the longer the term, the more the risk is for the investor. So they're going to give you that rate lock for that 60-day period. They don't know what rates are going to be in 60 days, so they're just going out on a limb and saying that they're going to be okay with it.
Absolutely. Floating, you may have heard the term floating. That just simply means that you're deciding to not lock your rate at that moment. Give an example. You come in, you meet with me, you sign documents. We're at day number one on processing your mortgage, and you're an optimistic person, and you feel like, hey, I really believe these rates are going to keep dropping. You're choosing the float. You're not having me secure that rate. You're going to check back with me maybe the next day, the following week, typically up to about a week before closing, you can let these rates flow, if you will, and you're truly gambling that you're going to be able to get that same interest rate you had or better. I mean, you really only do it if you tend to get a better rate. So you got to ask yourself, are you the gambling type or not? How's that payment look with the interest rate that the lender can give you that day versus maybe what it could be if rates got better? Is it worth the gamble, or do you want to go ahead and just lock it in?
And there's been a lot of that on that. And we get the same questions a lot of times, you know, are rates going to get better or are they going to get worse, you know? And unfortunately, we don't have that magical ball behind our desk that we can turn around and look at. So, like we were talking earlier, it's just a guessing game at this point. And typically, the best thing to do on it when you're looking at it is we'll go through the payment with your taxes, insurance, PMI if you have it on your loan, and that payment. And if you can legitimately save money on your payment, the best thing to do is lock it in. Yes, can rates get better? Yes. Can it get worse? Yes. And that's the whole problem is that if you're wanting to get 4.75 or 4.875 and you can get 5% today, nobody can guarantee it's going to get that low.
Don't pass on a good thing, especially if you're talking about refinancing. If you're at 6.5% and you're getting quoted a 5% interest rate, that's a pretty good reduction. I mean, don't walk past a $100 bill looking for the $1,000. I mean, just take the savings. I'd like to end on this note. Market forecast. I mean, don't you just never know what's going to happen with these rates. I can't emphasize that enough. We have enough data coming to us from, like Steve said, in these emails that we get to give you a general idea of what may happen tomorrow. So if I've got a client in my office at 4:30 and we're talking about rate locks, I may give them a good guess on what the next day may bring. That's it. No one else is any smarter than that, all right? If you're talking to someone who's guaranteeing your rates are going to hit a certain percentage, they're completely filling you full of hype. There's no way of knowing it. I mean, a number of things can happen in the stock market, unexpected things that can happen in the stock market that could massively affect what these rates do. So use your judgment. Look at what the rates are. Look at what they have been historically. Know a good deal when you see it. Lock in your interest rate.
Take care of it. Well, that should take care of it for this week's episode. Thanks for watching. Tune in next week. David from Las Vegas contacted us on Plaxo, and he's wanting to find out about escrow accounts. So we'll be talking about that next Friday.
Exactly. Escrows. What is it? What's it mean to escrow? How does it affect you? We'll see you then.